Yes, guys, read the question number 8. The following are the particulars of three companies. Ascertain the value of goodwill. Assets are to be revalued. Goodwill is to be valued at 4 years purchase of average super profits for 3 years. Such average to be calculated after considering adjustment of depreciation at the rate of 10% on increase or decrease on revaluation of fixed assets. Guys, whenever there is an increase in the valuation, if the revaluation is upward, then there is additional depreciation. When the revaluation is downward, then impact on income tax can be ignored. Normal profits NRR is 10%. Capital employed to be considered on the basis of revalued amount of tangible assets. So the values are given there. The revaluations are also given below in another table. Revaluation of tangible block, current assets, and average annual profits of 3 years before charging debenture interest. This is not current year profits, guys. It is given as an average. So when you have to calculate average for capital employed, we have to deduct half of current year profits from closing capital employed. Current year profits are not given. So let's start with the first determinant, FMP. NRR is already given. I need only two determinants. One is FMP. Second one is capital employed. So I'll start with FMP. Maintain three columns, P, Q and R. Average profits before debenture interest. Everything is given in lakhs. Let me convert everything into lakhs again. Average profits will be 3.6, 2.88 and 1.56. 2.88, 1.56. This is before debenture interest. So, less debenture interest. Check the balance sheet. Debentures, 10% debentures are 4, nil and 2. So 0.4 debenture interest and 0.2 debenture interest. Interest should be reduced from the profits. One more adjustment for FMP is regarding your depreciation on revaluation given in point number 2. Average is to be calculated after adjusting depreciation at the rate of 10% on the increase or decrease in the revaluation. So depreciation on revaluation. Of tangible assets, not for current assets, guys. Depreciation is only for tangible fixed assets. Check. Tangible block for P is 16 in the balance sheet, 20 lakhs as far as your revalued figure. So 4 lakhs upward revaluation. If depreciation impact at the rate of 10%, 0.4 extra depreciation, deduct your profits. Next for Q. Balance sheet is 12, revalued figure is 10, reduced by 2 lakhs, 10%, 0.2 plus. Increase the profit because depreciation is reduced. R, 10 lakhs as per the book value, 12 lakhs as per the revalued figure, 2 lakhs upward revaluation, depreciation of 0.2 reduce. That's it. This will give you what are your FMP. Or average profits. There is no tax to be considered. There is 2.8, 3.08 and 1.16. These are your FMPs. I can't calculate closing capital, average capital employed, so I'll use only terminal capital employed. Use the revalued figures to calculate your closing capital employed. Start with your assets. Under assets. Tangible assets. at revalued figures and also your current assets at revalued figures. You can fill it up from the table which is given below the balance sheet. I will not consider goodwill because I am valuing goodwill. I am writing everything in lakhs. So 20, 10, 12 tangible block. Current assets 7, 2.8 and 1.6. Total assets are 27, 12.8, 13.6. First one is creditors, the second one is 10% debentures. Creditors 4, 3, 2, debentures 4, 0, 2, liabilities 8, 3. We can already the third determinant is given. Employed, you know.